Hello.
Hello, Ale. Good
Hi, Ale.
evening.
How are you?
Fine, you?
I'm good. Thank you for asking.
Welcome.
Our Friday. Yay.
Solo nosotras estamos.
Ahorita sí, for some reason. Así que thank you so much for joining. A ver qué ha pasado. Se tomaron muy en serio lo de que era nuestro Friday.
Ah, puede ser.
But we'll see, we'll see, we'll see. All right, vamos a ponerlo en el chat in case they forgot. Remember, we do have class today. Smiley. All right. Bueno, anyways, hoy vamos a hacer mucha practice. And also, we were going to start reviewing statements with the past of be. Para ya comenzar con la section 5. Pero veamos, esperemos unos minutos a ver si more people join. Excellent, thank you. All right. Yay, excellent. I do see that Danny just joined. Perfect. Awesome. Hi, Danny. Good evening. How are you? Awesome. I see Nestor just joined. Hello.
Good evening, teacher.
Hi, Nestor. How are you?
Hi.
Excellent. That's okay. No problem. Eso estábamos diciendo que maybe se tomaron muy en serio lo del Friday. All right. We are just four people right now. Okay, five. Ya se unió Rocío. Excellent. Five. All right, guys, let's just wait for a couple of minutes para que veamos si se une alguien más. All right, excellent. Ahora sí, ya nos estamos uniendo. Awesome. I see Sergio, Marta, and Nubia just joined. Perfect. Excellent. Don't worry. We are on time, guys. Perfect. Excellent. Let's see what no one's writing down. Awesome, guys. How are you? Today's our Friday. Remember that we don't have class tomorrow. Tomorrow, we don't have class. So today is our Friday, and that's great. I see Christian just joined. Excellent. Perfect, guys. How are you today? Are you excited? How do you feel? Are you tired from working? Are you good? How are you?
I am right.
Excellent, Nubia. I'm glad to hear that. Estoy viendo que me están diciendo que tienen problemas para conectarse. Let's try to restart the internet. Excellent. All right. Hopefully that works. And it is 8:06, guys. And today we are going to begin our class by doing an exercise. In the past couple of days, you've been practicing the simple past in groups. You've been doing some exercises. I understand that we didn't finish all of them, right? But I think that we got most of it done, or a big part of it done. Creo que se hicieron bastantitos y trabajaron bastantito. So today I am going to be checking those with you guys. And also we're going to be doing a new exercise, todos juntos, so that we see how we are doing. All right, and then we are going to start reviewing the statements with the past of be, which is section 5's first topic, right? All right, so let's check this out, guys. This is today's exercise. This is today's exercise. Can you see the screen? ¿Pueden ver esta pantalla?
Yes. Yes.
Awesome. Yes. Cool. Perfect. Love that. So, una pequeña recapitulación, un pequeño recap, right? These are regular verbs. The regular verbs are the ones you just add ed to. Vamos a ponerlo aquí. Regular verbs in yellow. I feel like yellow, right? Regular verbs. Oops. You just add ed. Right? That is our rule. Or most important rule. Pass with irregular verbs, you just add ed. And for irregular verbs, it's a completely different word. Es una palabra diferente para los irregular verbs. Esto es como se vería una oración positiva usando un verbo en pasado. Any subject or any pronoun. He played, she played, I played tennis. And in the negative form, we have to use didn't, right? We have to use didn't. Para el negativo, usamos siempre didn't. En el pasado simple. I didn't play tennis. Cuando hacemos una pregunta, siempre comenzamos con did, then the subject or the pronoun, then the verb, in present form. ¿Por qué en presente el verbo? Porque did ya está conjugado. And then we use the complement, right? Whatever we want to say. Siempre usando did. And to answer yes or no questions, que es lo último que vimos. Oops, I'm sorry. Whoops, there we go. Okay. ¿Qué es lo último que vimos? Yes or no questions. We answer using yes, I did, or no, I didn't. O si nosotros queremos, podemos dar más information, right? Any questions, guys? ¿Alguna pregunta hasta aquí antes de que comencemos el exercise?
No.
Cool. All right. No questions?
No.
Perfect. All right. Yes, I know you are very smart. You are great. So, let's do an exercise, guys. Vamos a intentar practicar los verbos. Remember that these are regular verbs. Por lo tanto, la terminación será igual. Quiero escuchar su pronunciation y las formas, por ejemplo, negativas del verb and the usage of yes or no questions. Así que vamos a ir haciendo one each, una cada uno. I'm going to be calling you out and quiero escuchar those pronunciations of the verbs, right? Recuerden que todos estamos aprendiendo. We are all learning. Las pronunciaciones de los verbos, el ed, como se escriben igual y se dicen diferente, yo sé que es un poco tricky. It may take some time. That's fine, right? Así que si lo corrijo, no es porque, uy, no puede, vea, sino que es para que vayamos aprendiendo la pronunciation. All right. So, veamos el ejemplo. Nos da el verbo en paréntesis o las palabras que debemos usar en paréntesis. For example, I. Nos dice que debemos usar wait. But since we are using the past, what is the past tense of wait? Waited. So, I waited 10 minutes for the bus. Right? Excellent. So let's go ahead and start with, vamos a ver aquí mi listita. We are 12 people and we have 15 exercises. That's cool. All right. Let's go ahead and start with Marta. Hi, Marta.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, thanks.
Excellent. All right, Marta. Can you give me the answer for number two? He usually walks to work, but he
didn't walk to work yesterday.
Excellent. But he didn't walk. Perfect, Marta. Yes. Walk, el verbo en presente porque ya conjugamos didn't. Perfect. All right. Let's continue with Ale. Hi, Ale.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine. Thanks.
Excellent. Can you give me the answer for number three? Son dos.
Surprise.
Mm-hmm. Uy, no cabe. Yeah.
Could.
Excellent. Cooked. Perfect. Vamos a cambiar el color for each person. All right. Excellent. Now, excellent, Ale. Let's continue with Briselda. Hi, Briselda.
Hi, teacher. Good night.
Hi, how are you?
Fine.
Excellent. Can you please answer number four?
Yes, is order.
Mm-hmm. ¿Y esta la primera? Aquí hay un blank.
Are you? Are you order?
Remember que estamos haciendo las questions con the past.
Wait, espéreme.
Sí, por favor.
Did you
correct? Excellent. Your food, and then?
Yes, we did.
Excellent, Briselda, perfect. Yes, did. Comenzamos, siempre que usamos las preguntas, debemos comenzar con did. Did you order en presente? Porque estamos usando ya el did, and we answer with the same verb. So yes, yes, we did. Yes or no questions, perfect, Briselda. Thank you so much. All right. Oh, let teachers tengo problemas con mi grupo. Okay, that's okay, no problem. Perfect. Let's go ahead and continue with Cristian. Cristian Molina.
Okay, my friend didn't play tennis because it was too hot outside.
Excellent. That is correct. My friends didn't play tennis because it was too hot outside. Perfect, Christian. Excellent. Play in the present because we already did, because we already used didn't, right? Excellent. Okay. Let's go ahead with Rocio. Hi, Rocio.
Hi, teacher.
How are you?
Very nice.
Excellent. Can you provide me with the answer for number six? We need two.
Troy wanted to study for the final exam.
Correct. Excellent. Troy wanted to study for the final exam. ¿Por qué debemos colocar study in the present? Guys?
Porque ya está uno al principio. Ya
correct. Está. That is correct. Porque una vez que ya conjugamos un verbo, los demás van en presente. So Troy wanted to study for the final exam. That is correct. Now, let's go ahead with number seven, Jennifer. Hello, Jennifer, are you here? Okay, no problem. Let's go ahead with Marlene. Are you here, Marlene?
Hi.
Hi, Marlene, how are you?
Good. Number seven.
Yeah.
First, we boil the water and then we pour into a cup.
Excellent. And then we pour it into a cup. ¿Por qué pour en presente? Porque ya conjugamos boiled, right? Si ya conjugamos un verbo, los demás van en present. So first, we boiled the water. Excellent pronunciation. And then we pour it into a cup. Pour, lo echamos, digámoslo así. Cuando es un líquido, we pour it. We pour liquid, we pour orange juice into the cup, right? Now, can I please have number eight? Denny, your microphone doesn't work, right? No funciona el micrófono, right, Denny? Yeah, I think her microphone doesn't work. That's okay. Now, can I please have Nestor, number eight?
Did they launch it? Mm-hmm. Your rocket? No, they. No sé cómo sería el final.
Sabemos que tenemos que contestar las yes or no questions con no, I didn't, or no, they didn't, no, they, or, yes,
no, they
I did.
No,
all right, remember, guys, sí, siempre es yes or no questions with yes, I, he, she, they, we, whatever, did or no, pronoun didn't, right? So, excellent. We stored all questions in the past using did. And we use the verb in the present. Eso sí, remember, aquí no sería loved, sería laugh, porque ya conjugamos did, right? Did they laugh at your joke, chiste, right? No, they didn't. Ellos no se rieron. So no, they didn't. Perfect. Now let's do number nine, Nubia.
What time did you arrive at school this morning?
Excellent, Nubia. Perfect. What time did you arrive at school this morning? Perfect. Now, let's see. Let's do number 10, Rita.
Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin landed on the moon in July 1969.
Perfect, Rita, excellent. They landed, excellent. And let's do number 11, Sergio.
Good night.
Hi, Sergio, good night.
What did you do last Saturday?
Perfect, yes. Ahí había espacio para confundirnos, right? Because there's only one verb. Excellent job, Sergio. Perfect. What did you do last Saturday? Correct. Yes, we can use the same verb twice. Porque did hace la función de auxiliary verb, como auxiliar, right? To indicate the past, indica el pasado. And do as a regular verb, right? Como un verbo regular, de hacer, do. And so, haciendo la función de auxiliary and haciendo la función de verbo normal. Now, let's see, who am I missing? I think we all did one, but I see that we are 13 people. Who? Oh, because Denny didn't do it, right? Porque she, her microphone doesn't work. So Sergio did do it, Rita did do it, Nubia, Nestor, Marlene, Jennifer. Oh, Jennifer, and isn't Jennifer. Hi, Jennifer, are you here? Or maybe her microphone doesn't work either. Okay. So yes, guys. So in that way, we did one exercise each. Before we go ahead and review the exercise that you did in groups, antes de revisar los ejercicios que hicieron en groups, does anyone have any question? ¿Alguien tiene alguna pregunta de este exercise?
No.
Is it clear? No? Perfect. All right. Okay. Cool. In that case, let's go ahead and review the exercises that you already did. Give me 1 second to put that up. Let's see, I have that right here. Let's start with this one. Comencemos con este. Let's see, that's loading. Come on. Okay, there we go. Perfect. No, you know what? We're going to start with this one, I think. Yes, let's do this one. Vamos a hacer irregular verbs. Okay. Were you guys able to work on this one? ¿Pudieron trabajar con este?
Yes.
Cool. Excellent. So, you know that this is all about irregular verbs, right? These are irregular verbs. Lo que acabamos de estar haciendo era para regular verbs, and now we are working with irregular verbs. So, let's go ahead and do the same thing. We're going to do one each and see how we do, okay? So, let's, oops, I'm sorry. There we go. And do one each. We have more than enough. So let's, I'm going to put up my list here. My grading list, perfect. We are 12 people right now. All right. So let's go ahead and start from the top. Iniciamos de nuevo. And let's go ahead and start with Marta once again. Number one.
Okay. Daisy brought, así?
Yes.
Brought some chocolate to the birthday party.
Excellent, Marta. Thank you. Daisy brought, yes, that is correct. She brought, whoops, perfect. Daisy brought some chocolates to the birthday party. All right. Let's go ahead with number two, Ali.
Yo no lo hice, pero no sé si será I heard a new song on the radio.
Correct. Yes. I heard. El pasado de hear is heard. I heard a new song on the radio. Perfect. Let's do number three. Briselda.
Yes. Red.
Yes, correct. Red. Si pueden, lean toda la sentence, please. So, yes, sería red.
Okay, Peter read three books last week.
Excellent, Briselda. Thank you. Peter read three books last week. Se escribe igual, but it is pronounced differently. Peter read three books last week. Excellent. Son homógrafos, homographs. Se escriben igual, pero suenan diferente. Now,
Alejandra. Vuelvo a pronunciarlo todos, porfa, para ver la diferencia.
Ah, yes, of course, of course. So, in the past, en el pasado, in the past it's red, como el color, right? Red. Red. Y en el presente es read, like pronounced read.
Ah, okay. Thank you.
Perfect. Of course. Y en su verbo participio, que ustedes lo van a ver después, actually in the next module lo van a ver que el participio igualmente es read. Pero mejor ni les comienzo a hablar de eso. Now, let's go with number four, Christian. Hello, Christian, are you here? All right, no problem. Let's continue. We'll come back to Christian. Denny's microphone doesn't work. Rocio.
Okay. The Smith spoke Italy to the wireless.
Correct. The Smiths spoke. That is correct. They spoke Italian to the waitress. The past tense of speak is spoke. Excellent. Let's go ahead with number five. Jennifer, are you here, Jennifer? I think she's not here, but I just want to make sure. Okay, no problem. Let's ask her to unmute. Okay.
No.
Okay, no problem. In that case, let's do number five, Madeline. Hello.
Oh, perdón. Peter understood during the class.
Excellent, yes. Peter understood during the class. Lo voy a poner aquí porque no me cabe. Understood. The past of understand is understood. Now, let's do number six. Nestor. Hello, Nestor.
Hola, estaba hablando con el micrófono.
No problem, no problem.
My mother forget to buy some Smith.
Is forget the past tense of forget? ¿Ese es el pasado de forget?
I don't know.
Okay, ¿cuál sería el pasado de forget, guys?
Forgot.
Correct. Excellent. So the past tense of forget is forgot. All right. Practiquemos siempre los past tense. Nos van a servir mucho. Now let's do number seven. Nubia.
Susan had a baby in August.
Excellent. Susan had a baby in August. Perfect. Let's do number eight. Rita.
We lost our case last Friday.
Yes, that is correct. We lost. The past tense of lose is lost. We lost our keys last Friday. Keys, llaves, right? Our keys. And let's do number nine, Sergio.
Okay. They swam 500 yesterday afternoon.
Correct. Yes, they swam. The past tense of swim is swam. They swam 500 meters. Ahí la M, igual que en español, metros. So meters. Okay. Yeah. Yesterday afternoon. Perfect. Now let's see. Let's go back to the people who weren't able to answer. Okay, Christian's not here anymore, but we have Christian Castro. Hi, Christian.
Hi, teacher.
How are you?
Tired.
Are you, you just get out of work?
Yes.
I understand that.
Okay.
And we are doing an exercise, Christian, using irregular verbs. Could you tell me what the past tense of give is? De la número 10. Do you know what the past of give is?
Yes.
Sure.
Yes, yes. Deck.
¿Cómo sería?
Es G-A-B-I.
B-E, así.
Yes.
O V-I.
Con E.
E, correct.
E, perdón, E, perdón.
No problem, no problem. Sí, siempre suele haber esa confusión a veces. That's okay. Es bien como esa confusión de E, I, and A, right? Porque A a la E, I a la A, but no. So yeah, that's okay. Correct, excellent. I gave, and that is pronounced gave, my mother a CD for her birthday. Now, un homónimo que pueden encontrar para gave es que a los jóvenes que se llaman Gabriel, right? En Estados Unidos les dicen Gabe. Pero Gabe así, right? Gabe. So, puede que ustedes lleguen a escuchar Gabe gave his mother a CD. And you have to know, right? Like gave the name and gave the verb. Homónimos. Suenan igual, se escriben diferente. No, homófonos. Suenan igual, se escriben diferente. Now, es más, lo voy a quitar para que no nos confundamos. And now we were also waiting to hear from Jennifer. Jennifer, are you here?
Hello.
Hi, Jennifer, you're back.
Hi, good evening, teacher.
Hi, good evening. We were waiting for you.
I'm sorry, mis audífonos creo que no servían.
That's okay. All right, Jennifer, in that case, now that you're back, let's go ahead and do number 11.
At the age of 23, she became a teacher.
Excellent. Yes, that is correct. At the age of 23, she became. The past tense of become is became. Lo voy a poner aquí porque no me cabe. Or maybe it does. I'm not sure. Let's see. Yes, it does. It does fit. Perfect. And I see that William just joined. Hi, William. Whoops. And he left. Okay. He was just here and he left the meeting. No problem. Okay, so in that case, guys, let me just see something real quick. This where, wait. This where, somewhere. Okay, no problem. All right, guys. De este ya hicimos un ejemplo, each one of us. Todos ya respondimos one example. Do you have any questions, guys, about this exercise? ¿Alguno que les haya dado problemas or that you don't know how to answer? Or is it clear? It was easy, right?
Ale, el de tel.
Okay, el number 13, is it?
Yes.
All right. Correct. Yes, correct. The past tense of tell is told.
Told, okay.
Told. Excellent. And what is the past tense of know, number 12?
New.
No se pronunciaría ese. New.
Correct. New.
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 New. Como new sin la K, right? New.
Okay.
Yeah. Most of K's in English are silent. But yeah. So yeah. I knew. I know, right? The past tense of know is new. And what is the past tense of lend, number 14?
Lent.
Correct. Lent. And for drink?
Yeah. Drunk.
Drunk or drank?
Drunk.
Drunk.
Drunk, correct.
Drunk.
Sí. Drunk es el participio, right? Pero ya le, no nos vamos a meter en eso todavía. Drunk es otra cosa. Siempre the drink, pero otro tiempo. Now, what about sleep?
Slept.
Correct. Slept.
Slept.
Con la T al final. Slept.
Slept.
Correct. Excellent. And what about keep?
Kept.
Kept.
Kept. Kept. Correct. Past tense of keep, kept. Estamos viendo un common theme con los que terminan en EP. La mayoría de los verbs que terminan en EP se les cambia por PT en irregular, pero no es una regla, right? Pero les puede dar una idea en, con algunos verbos. So slept, kept, cadded, etc., etc., etc. Now, let's clear this screen and let's move on to number 18. What about number 18, guys? Choose. Correct. Chose. So I choose or I chose. And film for number 19?
Began.
Began.
Correct. The film began. And number 20, fly?
Flew.
Flow.
Flow or flew?
Flew.
Correct. Flew. Excellent. And what about number 21, drive?
Drove.
Correct. Drove. ¿Quieren saber algo bien interesante? This word, how would you pronounce? Uy, que se me hizo el mouse. Okay, here it is. How would you pronounce this word? Los que hayan visto la serie de Netflix, no lo digan. How would you pronounce that word? La lógica nos dice que debería de ser pronunciada Edinburgh, right? Eso nos dice la lógica. But since English doesn't make any sense, this word is pronounced, it's a city or a town in England, it's pronounced Edinburgh. It doesn't make any sense. No me pregunten por qué, no tiene sentido, but son facts interesantes. Por si lo llegan a ver en algún lado, it's pronounced Edinburgh or Edinburgh. De manera moderna, pues se dice Edinburgh, right? Como que dijeran Edinburgh, así, Edinburgh. But antes le decían Edinburgh, porque los ingleses de la realeza tenían una cierta forma de hablar que ahora se considera errónea, que en que pronunciaban la R como R, porque tenían mucha influencia romana y había gente que hablaba romano, right? So they did pronounce the R, y eso se fue perdiendo poco a poco, right? So en, digamos, Europa de 1800, ustedes escucharían que la pronunciación del inglés correcto sería "We drove to Edinburgh". Y esa era la pronunciación correcta del inglés en aquel entonces. Now we say "We drove to Edinburgh". Para que vean cómo cambian las cosas, sin que nada es cierto. Todos nos complicamos de por gusto. ¿Se imaginan lo fácil que sería pronunciarlo si todavía se pronunciara así el inglés como regla? We drove to Edinburgh. Fuera más fácil para nosotros, right? That we speak Spanish. But since things are not meant to be easy, I guess. Ese es el fact del día. Edinburgh. Let's continue with number 22. Teach.
Touch.
Tot. That's correct.
¿Cómo es la pronunciación?
Se pronuncia tot.
Tot.
Tot. Tot. Como tot. Así, tot.
Okay.
Excellent. What about number... Excellent, Nestor. What about number 23? Send.
Sent.
Sent.
Perfect. Sent with a T. And number 24, leave.
Left.
Left.
Correct. Left, como el lado, right? Como left, izquierda. Así es el verb también, left. Excellent.
7 a.m.
Lo mismo sucede con los plurales y los singulares. Los que estudiaron conmigo se recordarán que se los comenté. ¿Qué sucede cuando termina con F? Beef, su plural es beefs, right? Elf, su plural es elves. Algo así sucede con los irregular verbs que terminan en VE, casi siempre es FT, casi siempre. Ojo, no les estoy diciendo que siempre será así. All right. So, any questions, guys? Hasta aquí. No, estamos super clear. Super clear con el past.
Yes.
Awesome. Love that. Eso era super importante para mí, que estuviéramos super, super clear con el past, porque después ustedes, a medida avancen, van a comenzar a ver the past perfect, más versiones del pasado, the present perfect, que tiene que ver también con el pasado, pero con el presente. Ahorita no tiene sentido, pero you will see, y se acordarán de mí. So yeah, guys. Sé que hemos hecho ejercicios hasta el cansancio, pero that was the point, que estuviéramos súper claros con the past tense. Por eso les pregunto, si you have any questions, you can let me know, porque esto es súper, súper importante que quede bien clear. Y pues los irregulares, que son con el tiempo, la práctica y la memoria, right? Excellent. Remember to practice on your own, watching movies, listening to music, y eso les puede ayudar mucho a obtener vocabulary. All right, guys. So, in the last minutes of today's class, we are going to start reviewing the statements with the past of be, which is the first topic of section 5, right? And we're going to do so by reviewing a conversation. Como siempre, cuando comenzamos un topic, we review a conversation, right? So, hoy no vamos a hacer two volunteers que lean toda la conversation, sino que vamos a leer one sentence each. All right, so let me just see. There we go. That way se lee el último. So we are 13 people and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Lo vamos a hacer entre dos. 10, 11, 12. Perfect. Cool. Okay. So we're going to start again. Nos vamos a turnar para leer this conversation. And we're going to go from the top. From the top. Okay. Let's go ahead and start with Marta. This one.
Okay. Where were you born, Melissa?
Thank you. Let's go ahead, Ale.
I was born in Korea.
Perfect. Let's go, Briselda. Hello, Briselda. Okay. All right, no problem. Let's go with Christian.
Oh, so you weren't born in the U.S.?
Excellent. Let's go. Danny's microphone doesn't work. Rocío.
No, I can't hear. In 1999.
Excellent. Yes. Let's go, Jennifer. Hello, Jennifer. There we go.
Melissa, yes, I was only 17.
Ay, íbamos con Chuck, pero bueno, sigamos así. You were pretty young. Yes, I was only 17. Okay, cool. Let's go with Nestor. Read Chuck here.
Did you go to college right away?
Correct, to college. And let's continue, Nubia.
Todo hasta donde dice first, o solo la, el párrafo primero.
Sí, todo, todo, porque no está diciendo.
Okay. No, my English wasn't very good, so I took English classes for 2 years first.
Thank you. Then let's continue, Rita.
Well, your English is really good now.
Perfect. And Sergio.
Okay, thanks. Your English is pretty good too.
Excellent. And Briselda, are you here? Okay, so let's just finish. Yeah, but I was born here. Excellent, guys. So, ¿qué podemos ver de esta conversation? Where are you born, Melissa? I was born in Korea. She was born in Korea, right? And oh, so you weren't born in the US. No, I came here in 1999. You were pretty young. Yes, I was only 17. Did you go to college right away? No, my English wasn't very good. So I took English classes for 2 years first. Well, your English is really good now. Thanks, your English is pretty good too. Yeah, but I was born here, right? So they are at a salon. Por la imagen podemos ver que they're at a salon and Chuck's doing Melissa's hair, right? So, ¿qué tenemos que poner atención? ¿Qué tenemos que fijarnos en esta conversation? Since we are reviewing statements with the past of be, ¿cuál es el past of be, guys? Tenemos two options.
Where and was.
Correct. Where and was. Esos son los dos past que tenemos para the verb to be. So we can see that here, where were you born? Here, I was born in Korea. So you were and born inside the US. You were pretty young. My English wasn't very good. I was born here, right? Todos estos son statements with the past of be. ¿Por qué es importante que, por qué tenemos un topic solo sobre statements with the past of be? Well, because that is what you are going to use in a conversation if you are talking about yourself or someone else, a la otra persona con la que estemos hablando in the past, right? Si queremos decir, yo nací en tal lugar, yo estuve en tal lugar, o cualquier cosa, o esto fue de esta manera, una conversación real, right? You're going to be using the past of be a lot. Nosotros ya estuvimos haciendo práctica hasta el cansancio, como ustedes saben, but it is very important for that reason. Esa es la razón por la que es tan importante. Porque es quizás, si no el verbo que más van a ocupar, the past of be. Así como en el presente, right? Can we use the verb to be for everything? I am, you are. Entonces, de la misma manera, debemos usar siempre ese mismo verb to be cuando estemos en el pasado. Pues el verb to be in the past, right? So let's go ahead and read some of the examples. Algunos de estos ya los leímos en el reading, but let's go ahead again con sus versiones negativas. Vamos a leer ambos, positive and negative. All right, let's go ahead and read this one, Marta.
I was born in Korea. I wasn't born in the USA. US.
In the US. Excellent. No problem. All right. Let's read the next one. Let's read the next one, Rocio. This one. Both.
You were pretty young. You weren't very old.
Excellent. Let's do the next one, Marlene.
She was 17. She wasn't in college.
Perfect. She wasn't in college. And let's do the next one, Christian.
We were born in the same year. We weren't born in the same country.
Perfect. Thank you very much. And let's do the last one, Ale.
They were in Korea in 1998. They weren't in the US in 1998.
Excellent. They were in Korea in 1998 and they weren't in the US in 1998. Remember guys, very important que los países en inglés debemos pronunciarlos por su nombre en inglés. Claro que hay países que pues no cambian su nombre. El nuestro, for example, que es El Salvador, right? El Salvador, Nicaragua, Guatemala. Cambia quizás solo la pronunciación un poco, Venezuela, Brazil, sí se escribe diferente, se escribe con Z. Portugal, pero si vemos, por ejemplo, países como México, no le vamos a decir México, le vamos a decir
México.
Correct. México. Lo mismo sucede con Corea. Korea. A China, no le vamos a decir China, le vamos a decir
China.
China.
Got it. Excellent. China. A Russia. No le vamos a decir Rusia, le vamos a decir Russia.
Russia.
Uno muy importante y que escucho muy seguido que lo pronuncian de la misma manera, no aquí, right, sino que lo escucho usualmente, es este. Porque se escribe igual. How do you pronounce that, guys?
Australia.
Correct. So let's say Australia. Como Australia.
Australia.
Australia. Australia. Correct. Excellent. Y así tenemos muchos otros countries, right? We have countries que tienen un nombre completamente diferente. For example,
Germany.
Germany. Excellent. What else?
England.
England. What else? What other countries do you know?
Netherlands.
Correct. Ese es uno muy diferente, right? Netherlands. We also have Switzerland. Este es bien diferente from Suiza, right? Switzerland, Suiza. Y esto suele ser, se los voy a dar porque esto suele confundirse mucho. And Sweden es Suecia. So, esos son los que suelen confundirse seguido. So, Switzerland, Suiza, Sweden, Suecia. And then remember, siempre que digamos Brazil, es con Z en inglés. We also have countries that have completely different names. For example, Greenland. ¿Alguien sabe cuál es Greenland?
Groenlandia.
Excellent. Yes. Groenlandia. And what is Iceland?
Islandia.
Excellent. Correct. Y como que les hubieran puesto el nombre accordingly, ¿vea? Al revés, porque en Greenland es hielo y en Iceland son pastures. Es verde todo Iceland, pero bueno. Les pusieron el nombre al revés. So, yeah, guys. All right. So, we have just a few seconds left. It's about to be 9. It's already 9. So, tomorrow, we don't have class. Remember, we just have 1 week left. Next week, we are going to finish section 5. We're going to continue practicing and learning a lot. And yes, I see Ale clapping. We are almost done, guys. Almost, almost, almost done. Demos lo último la otra semanita y, well, rest. Ahorita descansen. We'll see each other on Monday, okay?
Okay, see you.
Okay, bye. All right, guys. Good night, thank you for joining today.
Good
bye.
Night. Good night, teacher.
Good night.
Good night.